We are having circle with a center O. Okay. If OP is perpendicular to AB, prove that AP equal to BP. So again, we are having a chord AB and OP is perpendicular to AB. Okay. We have to prove AP equal to What we have to prove? AP equal to BB. BB or BP it is written. AP equal to BP. Okay. They are same only. BP. Okay. We have to prove this side equal to this side. So how to prove? How we are going to prove? So first we have to join. So if we prove these two triangles are congruent. If we prove these two triangles are congruent, we can prove AP equal to BP. Okay. So which triangles we are we taking? So triangle
OAP.
OAP and triangle
OBP.
OBP. Okay. OBP we have taken. Okay. Now all the things. So first triangle here, second triangle here. Okay. So first, what will we write? Huh? What should we write? AP.
AP equal to BP.
Okay, this we have to prove. OP equal to OP. So take this triangle and take this triangle. OP is common. OP equal to OP. What is the reason? Common side. Okay. Second, what is given? OP is perpendicular to AP. It means this is 90 degree as well. This angle is 90 degree. Okay. So angle OPA. OPA equal to angle OPA, you can call like in Korean language. And it is next one OPB. Why? It is given in book only. Question OP is perpendicular to AB. Why? OP is perpendicular to AB. This is the reason. So this is 90, this is the 90. Third one, what you write? We require one more.
OA equal to OB.
OA equal to OB because they are radii of
radius.
The circle. Of the same circle, okay? So which theorem have we used? See here, this one and this. This side and this angle. Side, okay. What we are using? Tell me.
SAS.
SAS. Consider again. Okay. Sir. What we have taken? See, I am marking here with blue pen.
Right.
This side we have proved to be this one. This is common and this angle. So see here, hypotenuse side angle R H S by R H S. We have used R H S. Only one angle was there, so only one angle, that is right angle, it was there. Okay, SAS is not there. Side, side, angle. Okay, and so ASS, there's no theorem, only RHS holds true. RHS by RHS. Okay, have understood third?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what more we have to prove? We haven't proved yet. What we have to prove? AB equal to AP equal to BP. So we'll write first here.
Sir, but here we don't have side one to use RHS.
RHS we don't have or not. See here, OA equal to OB. This is what? Hypotenuse only. Hypotenuse of the first angle is equal to hypotenuse of the second. This is here. OP equal to OP. This is the side and this is the right angle, right angle. We have proved these two angles square. So isn't it RSS? RHS.
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, can't we take SAS?
How you are going to take SAS?
Sir, two sides are common and one angle are common. Sir, angle P is common both.
Okay, see here. This is the triangle. I am taking OAP. What we have proved? This side, this side, this. So, how it can be SAS? SAS only when this and this angle. All we have proved this angle and this angle. This side, this angle. Okay, SAS means two sides and the included angle. That is two sides and the included angle.
I got it.
Okay, RHS. OAP and here OBP. So which theorem? RHS. They are congruent by RHS theorem. Okay. Now as they are congruent means remaining everything will be corresponding things will be corresponding sides and angles will be equal or congruent. Now we can say AP equal to BP. Corresponding to AP, what is the side in the other triangle? PB. You can see AP opposite to this angle. Opposite to this angle. AP is equal to BP. What is the reason we write? CP, CTC. Congruent parts of congruent triangles are equal or are congruent. Okay. AP equal to BP. Hence shown or proved. Hence proved. Understood? These two triangles are congruent. It means all the corresponding parts will be congruent. Okay. It means.
Sir, understood.
AP equal to BP. This angle equal to this angle. This angle equal to this angle. Okay. Do the fourth one now. Fourth one. In a triangle ABC. So first make a triangle ABC. In a triangle ABC. Read the question first. Then make the diagram accordingly. Everyone read the question first. Fourth one. Okay. Diagram. Whatever diagram I'm making, you have to make the same. Okay. We'll follow the one rule only. Okay. You can make any kind of diagram in examination. Don't worry about that. Okay. So see here. In a triangle ABC, D is the midpoint on BC. BC. AD is produced to E. So that DE equal to AD. Okay. So first we are going to draw a triangle ABC. Okay. Always draw simple triangle. Okay. A, B, C. We have drawn the triangle. Okay. D is the midpoint of BC. D is here and it is midpoint of BC. It means BD equal to DC. Understood? Okay. Now E is produced. E is produced. AD is produced. Okay. AD is produced. Right? AD is produced up to E. Okay, and where we have to stop? Where AD equal to DE. For example, this length is equal to this length. This will be the E. We have to stop where AD equal to DE and join them. You got a figure like this. Okay. We got a figure like this. Okay. This angle we do not know what's the value of them. Okay, we do not know. Okay. What we know, we all know is D is the midpoint of BC. It means this length equal to this one. Okay. And we have produced AD such that AD equal to DE. It means AD is equal to DE. Only this much we know. Okay. Now, what we have to prove? Triangle ABD and triangle ECD. So, triangle ABD and triangle ECD. Which these two triangles are? ABD. ABD. This is our first triangle. Second triangle ECD. ECD. This is our second triangle. Yes or no? These two triangles, we have to prove that they are congruent. They are congruent. First triangle and second triangle. It is something like this. Okay. Little bit smaller, I write. It is something like this. This equal to this.
Yes, sir.
A, B, D, C, E. Okay. These two triangles we have to prove congruent. This is our first triangle. First triangle this side. Second triangle. Second, all the things of second triangle here. Okay. Now, so how to prove these are congruent?
BD equal to DC.
BD equal to CD, we have to say. If we are starting from BD, E, we start from C here. Okay. So here we are starting from BD. So CD. You can see here as well. BD, CD. Understood? Okay. Yes. Next one. Reason, AB what reason you write? D is the midpoint of BC. D is the midpoint of BC, given. Or you can write given. Okay. Now,
A.
Next.
AD equal to ED.
ED. AD equal to ED. You can see here from A we are moving to D. From E we will move to D. Okay. AD equal to ED. You can see AD equal to ED. Okay. This is also same.
So we can write DE also.
You can write DE also. Yes, you can write. But see, we are following some rules. Okay. Conventions we are following. So that everyone knows that this way we are writing, so that we can easily get it. We can easily grasp it. Yes or no? Like I have started from A, A to D are more. Okay. Such angle, this angle will be there, AD. Okay. So it can be given, you can write, or AD equal to D, that is given. Okay. Next one, one more thing we require. Either the angle or the side.
And the angle D is 90 degrees.
So 90 degrees.
Where is it written?
Sir, straight line.
How it is? Okay, for example, okay, if I make a diagram like this, okay, now what is being there? D is the midpoint of this line, A, B, C, okay, and this length equal to this length, okay, this will be the E point, D. Is the D point 90 at an, having the 90 degree angle, this side and this
no,
side?
No, sir.
No,
sir.
Just we have made it like this. So it seems like it's 90, but in reality, it can be any angle. It can be any angle. Yes or no? So till it is not given, don't take it as 90 degrees.
Sir,
till. Yes?
Sir, ADC is equal to ED.
ADC we don't require. ADC angle we don't require.
Sir, angle A is equal to angle E.
Angle A equal to angle
E.
E, why? Give me the reason.
Sir, they are interior opposite angle and there is a Z formation okay. Is also there.
Okay, okay. Interior opposite angles. When does it hold true? If we are having, if these two are parallel, then only. If two lines are, okay, 1 minute. If two lines are parallel and its line segment is cutting them, okay, these two lines are parallel, then these are interior alternate angles, okay, but here no parallel lines, so interior angles, just forget about that. Anything more? Okay, this angle we have checked, we can't prove now.
Sir, angle ADB,
ADB, okay,
and EDC,
angle EDC, okay, so why? Give me the reason. Without reason, I won't take. If they are equal, then why? Okay, if I draw a cross like this or cross like this, what about these angles? Are they equal? Opposite angles or not? If I two lines crosses, these angles will be equal or not? Or they cross like this, this angle will be equal to this angle. What kind of angles these two are?
90 degree.
Not 90 degree. These two angles will degree. Be equal or not? How you are
opposite
getting
angles.
When is it written it's 60 or 20 or 40 degree? It's not written, it means it's not provided. It can be of any degree. They are opposite angles. They are opposite angles. Take it like this. Okay, find the opposite angles. Are they equal or not? Can you see this angle and this angle? Or the top or the bottom angle? Are they equal?
Yes, sir.
They are yes, always sir. Equal. Why not? Take this angle and this angle. Draw any two lines. Opposite angles, this angle will be equal to this angle. This angle will be equal to this angle or not. Any way you write, draw. This angle will be equal to this angle. This angle will be equal to this angle. They are opposite angles. When two line segments cut each other, opposite angles are formed and they are always equal. Any way you cut. This angle will be equal to this angle and this angle will be equal to this angle. Don't forget about this one. So here these two angles are what? These two angles are what? Opposite angles?
Opposite angles.
Okay, these we don't, these are all opposite angle, they are equal. These two are equal. So what we can write next point? Okay, the starting questions, you may feel a little bit difficult, but soon you are going, yes. ADB, EDC, EDC it will be. You can see ADB, EDC, okay. ADB angle equal to EDC. What they are? Opposite?
Opposite angles.
Opposite angles. So which theorem we have used? Take any one triangle.
SSA. SSA. SAS.
Two sides and included angles. So these two triangles are congruent. ABD congruent to triangles angle, triangle ECD. Okay. Reason SAS theorem. Okay. And what we have to prove? That these two triangles are congruent. We have proved. Okay. Now second one. AB equal to EC. A, B equal to EC, we have to prove. How we can prove? A, B equal to
EC.
By CPCTs we can prove, because we have proved these two triangles are congruent. It means the corresponding parts are also congruent. So AB equal to EC, okay? AB equal to EC, CPCTC, okay? AB equal to EC. They are equal because corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent or equal. Okay. You can see angle side opposite to this, side opposite to this. They will be equal. Okay. Next one. AB is parallel to EC. Okay. Now tell me. AB is parallel to EC. We have to prove. I just told. Just go.
The rhombus property.
How is it rhombus? Are they at 90 degree? In rhombus, the diagonals bisect each other 90. Here, we do not know whether they are bisecting or not at 90 degree. So, it's not rhombus. We can't say it's rhombus or not. What happens? Okay, for example, if I two lines are draw, one line segment cross them, and if these two angles are equal, then their interior alternate angles, if they are equal, it means these two lines are conversely, we are doing, okay? What you have said is two lines are parallel, one line segment cuts them, then the alternate interior angles are equal, okay? Or the adjacent angles. Okay, adjacent, okay, forward adjacent. These are, what angles are forward? Corresponding angles? Corresponding angles are these. Okay, these are adjacent angles only. Adjacent angles are supplementary. Or these two, okay? So, main is the here we use alternate interior angles, okay? So how to prove that one? So what next we'll write? Angle, take any one angle, either this or this, this or this. For example, I'm taking this angle. So angle BAD, okay? Not bad, BAD, okay? Equal to angle BAD, we are taking CDE. CDE, they are equal. What is the reason? CP, CTC. CPCTC is the reason, because these two triangles are congruent, so corresponding parts are also congruent or equal. So this angle equal to this angle and this angle equal to this angle. So we are taking this angle and this angle. Since they are equal because of CPCTC, okay, now as they are equal, they are alternate interior angles. As they are equal, therefore AB parallel to EC. AB parallel to EC. Reason you can write because these two are out because of alternate angles. Angle BAD equal to angle CD, and you can write alternate interior angles in bracket even now. Okay. This is clear. Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you repeat that part again? I didn't understand that.
Okay, see here, how to prove AB is parallel to EC? How to prove? So can you see the two lines? See here, here see the lines AB, and here we have EC. Okay, and this is there. Okay, if I prove this angle equal to this angle, and here is the D point. Okay, can you see two lines and one line cutting both? So if I prove these two are these two angles are equal, if I prove these two angles are equal, I can prove that AB is parallel to CE. Yes or no? These two lines are parallel, we can prove. Okay, so what you are going to write? So first, angle PAD equal to angle CED. What is the reason? CPCTC. Since we have proved these are congruent, so these two angles are also equal by CPCTC. Okay, but these angles are what? As these are alternate interior angles, and therefore AB is parallel to EC. AB is parallel to EC. You can write like this because these are alternate interior angles. Okay, you have studied this one. If two lines are parallel, one line is cutting, then the alternate interior angles are equal. Yes or no? So if opposite we do, two lines are there, one line is cutting, and alternate interior angles are equal, then we can prove that these two lines are parallel. Okay, in conversely we are doing. Understood now? Everyone have understood?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. Help me.
A triangle ABC has angle B equal to angle C. Which kind of triangle is it? Angle B equal to angle C. In a triangle, if two angles are equal, the sides opposite to those two angles are also equal. Isosceles. That means having same legs, equal legs. Okay, next is ABC. So ABC, it means angle B equal to angle C. It means this side is equal to this side, equal legs of the triangle. Okay, now prove that the perpendiculars from the midpoints of BC, perpendiculars from the midpoints of BC to AB, midpoint of BC to AB. Okay, perpendiculars from the midpoint of BC. From here we are drawing. It means if D is the point, this is the midpoint of BC. The perpendiculars from the midpoint of BC. From the midpoint of BC, we are drawing perpendiculars to on AB and AC. This we are doing. Okay, so from this, BD is the midpoint of BC. Now from this one, draw the perpendicular. Okay, draw the perpendicular. Okay, I'm removing this one so that we don't get confused. Okay. Okay, I'm writing here AB equal to AC. This is already given. Angle B equal to angle C, we have done. And it is, we are saying EF, EF. Okay. This is clear. EF or PQ, you can mark anything. Okay, that's up to you. Okay. Now we have to, what we have to prove? What you have to prove? The perpendiculars drawn from the midpoint of BC to the sides AB and AC, these are equal. It means you have to prove DE equal to DF. This you have to prove. Since these are perpendicular on the side, means this angle will be how much? 90. This angle will be how much? 90. Okay. So how we are going to prove that this is equal to this one? Anyone in class? How can we prove?
Sir, by AAS property.
Okay, forget about property. Just tell me which triangles we should take. Property we'll discuss afterwards.
Sir, triangle EBD and triangle FCF DC.
Okay. So these two triangles we are going to take. Okay. E, B, D. And this is F. See, this angle, and this. Okay. And this is 90. Okay. These two triangles we are going to take. Okay. So triangle I'm writing, which we should start from E. E, we move B to D. E, B, D. And triangle, here we start from F, C, D. F, C, D. Okay. Okay. Now, how can we prove it? So we are going to prove that these two triangles are congruent. As these are congruent, corresponding parts will be equal. Yes or no? So we can get, okay, D equal to DF. Okay. Okay. Now, next, what will be the first? Any angle, any side you want, you tell. This is the first
angle. Sir, angle E is equal to angle F.
Okay. Angle E equal to angle F equal to 90 degree given. Okay. Second, you can also write angle E as DEB equal to DFC, angle DFC. You can write this also. Okay. Next one. Better.
So, can you tell the second part given in the book?
Which one, second part? The perpendiculars, okay, first part we are discussing, second part we'll take afterwards, okay? First part we are discussing first, fifth first. So, we'll write angle DEB, DEB, okay, DEB equal to angle DFC, DFC, okay? Equal to 90 degree, okay? Okay, next one.
Sir, you have written there DED.
Okay, D, okay, D. D, D, E, B. Okay, sorry for that. D, E, B. Okay. Now, next one. Which one we should take?
Angle B is equal to angle C.
Angle B equal to angle C. It's single vertex, so we can simply write angle B equal to angle C. It is given. Okay. Next one.
Sir, BD is equal to CD.
BD equal to CD. BD equal to CD. Why? Because D is the midpoint of D is midpoint of BC. Okay. So which we have used? CS, yes. angle right. So AAS. So these two triangles are congruent by AAS. Okay. Theorem. Triangle EBD and triangle FCD. Okay. Now what we have to prove? Since these two triangles are congruent, all the remaining parts, corresponding parts of the triangles are also equal or congruent, we can say. So now we can write D equal to DF. DE equal to DF. Why? CP, CTC. And hence we have proved that perpendiculars from the midpoints of BC to AB and AC are equal. Okay. This is clear? Okay. Second one, let's discuss for a minute, okay? Let you do as homework, okay? We'll discuss for a minute how the figure is going to be, okay? So, we are having the same triangle ABC. Two legs are equal, that is isosceles triangle, okay? A, B, C. This angle equal to this angle, this side equal to this side. So, AB equal to AC, I'm writing, okay? Okay, now what is given? The perpendiculars from B and C. Perpendiculars from B, perpendiculars from C on the opposite, to the opposite sides are equal. This we have to prove. So draw the perpendicular from B. This is the perpendicular from B. Draw the perpendicular from C. This is the perpendicular from C. Okay. Mark points them as. Okay. P and Q are this. P, Q. Okay. Now we have to prove that. What we have to prove? BQ equal to CP. This we have to prove. BQ equal to CP. Okay. So you can see how the triangles are. Like this. BC. Okay. This whole angle equal to this one. Or if I draw, these triangles are like. First triangle, this one, P, B, C, 90. This angle is here, okay? And the other triangle, B, Q, C. Okay, what is given here? Angle C. Okay, have you got the things? These two triangles we can draw like this, we can draw separate like this as well. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can you prove the congruency now? Easily you can prove? Yes or no?
Yes, yes, sir.
90, 90, this, this. What about one thing? One thing is still remaining. Side, which side? Which side will you take? BC is common or not? BC?
BC. Yes.
BC is common?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Angle, angle, side. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
You can separate them. You can draw them separately. Understood? BC is common side. Take this triangle. BC is common. Take this triangle. BC is common. This angle equal to this angle. It is already given. This angle 90, 90. This angle, this side is common. Okay. So both the triangles are congruent. As both the triangles are congruent, it means BQ equal to CQ. It means this side and this side. They are also equal. This one and this one. CPCTC. Yes or no? You can see side opposite to angle B. Side opposite to angle C. This you have to go. This two are equal. So this do as homework. Have you all understood? 5 seconds.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So practice it, or else it will be trouble. Okay, because 9th B exercise little bit tough, and little bit more tough will come as we move forward. Okay, so practice these all. Okay, practice these all questions. You are on Sunday tomorrow. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, when you will upload the test?
At 3.
Sir, 3 p.m.
Yes, 3 p.m. I will upload. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So.